your question is, is about women in anthropology. Why was it then in the 40s, anthropology was one of the few fields where women could enter.
But do you think they came to the top of the profession? Because it's not true, you see. They did enter it, and they did extremely well, and they were very brilliant. But Margaret Mead was controlled by excluding. She was never in a teaching room in Colombia, and she was always doing adjunct teaching. She was always held up inside that museum all the time. She wasn't, because she was all around the world. I think she posed a great threat to them. And she got more and more bizarre as she got more and more excluded, of course, as you would. And Ruth Benedict was in a big teaching position. She had this tremendous feeling relation with Grace Linton. So I don't think that, although they did very brilliantly, it was by appealing to a wider public that they got their reputations, as Margaret Mead chose, rather than by making it through the ladder of promotions in the profession. And it's the same in England. I have my own theory about why women anthropologists do well and why they enter it. They don't do particularly well. I mean, given the number of women who go in for it, the few who do well are a very small number. Excuse me. But in England, the first woman to hold an anthropology chair, which is a very big responsible position in the subject, but is the only one you have to really influence the subject, is just this recently, Marilyn Strathern in Manchester. Otherwise, no woman has been chairman of a department, a permanent chair of a department. So they do well if they manage to write beyond the subject, but not if they stay narrowly professional, like they might be a historian.
What's your theory?
You mentioned that you I have a theory. My theory is that there's a shift in the occupational structure that gives big rewards. And as soon as there's economics that leads out of banking or industry or even under government treasury, a big theoretical and administrative field where there's power and influence, just take economics and take law. The men will really crowd for it because they really have to get into it. They're very competitive and they're very advantaged in competition. So that leaves a gap, and the women follow in to the places that they're moving out of. The case is illustrated by classics, because classics used to be entirely a male field. But then when you stopped having to know about Greece and Rome and speak Greek and Latin in order to be great civil servants or rulers of empire, the women started leaving in, and then the women started taking all the prizes, and you don't get any men in the humanities at all. So that's my explanation.
So it's a form of ghettoizing.
It's a negative explanation, yes.